7 signs of ovulation. Cervical mucus changes. As you near ovulation, your body produces more estrogen, causing cervical mucus to become stretchy and clear, like egg white, which helps sperm swim to the egg that's released during ovulation. Cervical mucus changes happen in most women, Moore says, but you have to know what you're looking for. The amount of cervical mucus and what it looks and feels like varies from woman to woman. To test it for ovulation, insert a clean finger into your vagina, remove some of the mucus and then stretch out the secretion between your thumb and finger. If it's sticky and stretchy or very wet and slippery, that's a good sign that you're in a fertile phase. Heightened sense of smell. For some women, a more sensitive sense of smell in the latter half of a normal menstruation cycle can be a sign of ovulation. In this fertile phase, your body is primed to be more attracted to the male pheromone androstenone. Breast soreness or tenderness. Breast and nipple sensitivity, tenderness or soreness can be another sign of ovulation, thanks to the rush of hormones entering your body right before and after ovulation. Mild pelvic or lower abdominal pain. Some women can actually feel ovulation, typically as a mild ache or pain in the lower abdomen, usually on one side or the other, not the same side each time. The sensation, called Mittelschmerz, can last anywhere between a few minutes and a few hours. You might also experience light vaginal bleeding, discharge or nausea along with the ache or pain, which is usually mild and short-lived. There's no need to worry about ovulation pain that goes away with an OTC, anti-inflammatory medication, such as Motrin, Moore says. But if ovulation pain is persistent or severe, see a doctor to rule out conditions such as endometriosis or an ovarian cyst. Moore suggests monitoring and recording your ovulation symptoms every month to get a sense of what is normal for your body, so you can more easily spot any abnormal ovulation signs and symptoms. When in doubt, check it out, she adds. Light spotting or discharge. Brown discharge or spotting during ovulation is normal if not that common. This ovulation symptom can occur when the follicle that surrounds and protects the developing oocyte, or egg, matures, grows and then ruptures, resulting in a small amount of bleeding. As blood gets older, it turns brown, which is why the vaginal discharge may range from red to dark brown. It's not a cause for concern unless the spotting persists, in which case you should see a physician to check for signs of infection and the possibility of an ectopic pregnancy if you've been sexually active. Libido changes. Some women notice that their sex drive increases during ovulation, which might be Mother Nature's way of ensuring we keep the species alive and well. But, as Moore says, sex drive can be influenced by just about anything, including whether you had a glass of wine or are just in the mood. Changes in the cervix. During ovulation, your cervix may become higher, softer and more open. You can check your cervix, along with your mucus, for ovulation symptoms, but it can take time to learn the differences you're feeling for and is often more difficult than watching for the other symptoms mentioned above. If you'd like to try and get more comfortable checking for cervical changes as a sign of ovulation, Moore recommends standing in whatever position you use to insert a tampon, for example, next to the toilet with one foot up on the closed seat, and using your finger to feel inside. In many women with a regular cycle, right before ovulation the cervix will be softer, like touching your lips, but after ovulation it will feel harder, more like touching the tip of your nose. An OB can also check for cervical changes using a speculum and help give you more guidance on how to do it at home.